Hey guys, in this video we will see our endogenous anticoagulant factors. We have seen that any break in blood vessel is sealed by formation of clot. During this process, platelets and various coagulation factors like thrombin, factor 10, 9, 11, 12, factor 5 and 8 and factor 7 are activated. Now, if these activated platelets and coagulation factors spread into this healthy undamaged area, they might start unnecessary clot formation over there. To prevent this, we have endothelial cells, antiplatelet factors like nitric oxide and PGI2, and a team of anticoagulant factors which includes antithrombin 3, heparan sulfate and heparin, thrombomodulin, protein C and protein S, and tissue factor pathway inhibitor. They prevent blood clotting in normal healthy vasculature. Let's see how do they do it one by one. First, endothelial cells. They have negative charge on the surface. Now, the platelet is also negatively charged. So, they are repelled from endothelium, which prevents platelet adhesion. It also prevents exposure of tissue factor to factor 7, which would otherwise initiate the extrinsic pathway of coagulation. Next, we have nitric oxide and PGI2 released from endothelium. They inhibit platelets. Next is antithrombin 3. It is released from liver. Thrombin and active factor 10, 9, 11 and 12 that leave the thrombus and enter into the circulation are inhibited by antithrombin 3. Next, heparin and heparan sulfate. Heparan sulfate is found on surface of endothelium. And heparin is released from mast cells and basophils. They both have little or no anticoagulant activity of their own. However, they help antithrombin 3 in inhibiting thrombin and other factors. They provide platform for antithrombin 3 and clotting factors to come closer and cause conformational changes in antithrombin 3 molecule, which exposes its active site. With this support, antithrombin 3 can inhibit thrombin and other factors at much faster rate. Next is thrombomodulin. It is found on surface of endothelial cells. Now we have seen in video of coagulation that thrombin is a procoagulant factor and it activates other procoagulant factors like fibrinogen, factor 5, 8 and 13 in coagulation cascade. But if thrombin leaves this damaged area, thrombomodulin modulates its function. So now this thrombin-thrombomodulin complex activates an anticoagulant protein called protein C. This brings us to protein C. It is released from liver and its synthesis is dependent on vitamin K. Protein C first binds with endothelial protein C receptor, which takes protein C to thrombin-thrombomodulin complex. Then it is activated to protein CA. This activated protein C inactivates factor 5 and 8 that enters into the circulation from clot. Factor S is a cofactor for protein C. Next is tissue factor pathway inhibitor. It's found in plasma and on endothelial cells. It inhibits factor 7A in tissue factor, factor 7A calcium complex of extrinsic pathway. It is done in two steps. First, it inhibits factor 10, and then this complex of tissue factor pathway inhibitor and factor 10 inhibits factor 7. Apart from these anticoagulant factors, fibrin formed during coagulation also helps in preventing clot formation at healthy sites indirectly. It absorbs thrombin molecules and thereby prevents its spreading into the remaining circulation. Because of this action, fibrin is also referred to as antithrombin 1. So these were the anticoagulant factors of our body. Now the summary. Endothelial cells have negative charge which repels platelets and prevents platelet adhesion. They separate tissue factor from factor 7 present in blood. Also they are source of nitric oxide and PGI2 and many anticoagulant factors. In antiplatelet squad, we have nitric oxide and PGI2. Needless to say, they inhibit platelets. Now anticoagulant factors. Antithrombin 3 inhibits thrombin, factor 10 and also factor 9, 11 and 12. Heparan sulfate and heparin have no intrinsic anticoagulant activity. However, they potentiate antithrombin 3. Thrombomodulin complexes with thrombin and thereby removes it from circulation. Also, it alters the behavior of thrombin, which then activates an anticoagulant, protein C. Protein C inactivates factor 5 and factor 8. Protein S serves as cofactor for protein C. Tissue factor pathway inhibitor first inhibits factor 10 and then factor 7. Fibrin absorbs thrombin and prevents it from spreading into the circulation. That's it, friends, for this video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.